These days, Kate Miller-Heidke's name is synonymous with that gravity-defying performance at last year's Eurovision Grand Final. But she's been dazzling us with those killer pipes for well over a decade. I was young and caught in the crowd. I didn't know then what I know now. The multi-platinum artist has produced 4 studio albums, won 4 Helpman Awards, and penned the original songs that turned Muriel's Wedding into a hit stage show. Coronavirus putting an end to her audiences and her income, Kate's joined over 1,000 Aussie musos in an open letter asking the government to pitch in until they can get back on the stage. And we can't wait for that.
And Kate Miller-Heidke joins us now. Kate, it's great to see you. Currently, people who work freelance or gig to gig are not entitled to the JobKeeper allowance. So how is that affecting people in the music industry?
Look, yeah, I think a lot of people are really struggling. As you say, you're only eligible for JobKeeper if you've had the same employer for a year, and that's just not how our industry operates. Some of the most seasoned, highly skilled, brilliant people in our industry work freelance and they work contract to contract, and so they're slipping through the cracks at the moment.
So the letter that has been written to the government, can you take us through what it's asking for?
Well, first of all, it's asking for JobKeeper to be extended to include those people who we were talking about before, particularly a lot of crew members, you know, a lot of lighting designers, sound design, the technical aspects of the mechs, all of those people need support at the moment. We're also asking for JobKeeper or some level of support to continue through beyond September because, I mean, unless there's some miracle, we're still going to be living with social distancing in September, and we won't be able to work.
It's hard to get audiences in any numbers if you've got social distancing in play. I know the government was having a meeting today, looking at a special package for the arts sector, which is taking exactly what you're talking about. Do you know what kinds of things they might be considering?
Look, I don't know. There's been nothing definitive announced yet. But I'm trying to be hopeful and optimistic that there'll be some level of recognition just about what our sector brings to Australia. It employs over 200,000 people. The arts brings in $16 billion a year to our economy, more than all sports combined. And it also brings people together and comforts people and inspires them and uplifts them, and I think that's unquantifiable.
And let's face it, Kate, ISO would have been impossible without the arts. I think people forget that. Imagine going through, you know, isolation without music, without the shows on TV, without movies, without, you know, all those things.
Absolutely. I mean, it would just be really miserable. I mean, I'm struggling already just being without live performance. I don't think I realised until now how much I use it to feel connected to other people, and that's where I get my hope from.
Oh, I've just started putting on shows at home, Kate. I hear you so much. Look, you've performed at Coachella, the Opera House, in Eurovision, whatever. Can you see...
One day am.
Oh, thank you. I'm holding on. Can you see events of that size happening anytime soon?
Not really. I mean, barring, yeah, a cure or a vaccine or, you know, if we can eradicate COVID in this country, that would be incredible, then we can be free with New Zealand. But no, we can't go back to normal for the foreseeable future.
Kate, you're an incredible songwriter. You're able to nail a pop song and then you can write and perform in an incredible opera. You've been working on a new album. How's that going?
Oh, look, it's been so exciting, actually, and a lot of fun. It's just being mixed at the moment. I think the very final track is being mixed right now, and I can't wait to share it with everyone.
Oh, well, then share it right now.
Yeah, I'm ready.
Okay.
Kate's new single, This Is Not Forever, is out now. Kate Miller-Heidke, it's been great to have you on the show. Thank you very much for speaking to us.
Such a pleasure. Thank you.